Good morning, children. Welcome again for the same chapter of history, from trade to territory, establishment of company power. In previous video, we studied about that the battle of Plassey fought between the company and Siraj-ud-Daulah, in which Siraj-ud-Daulah was defeated and the company got its first victory in India. First time the company won any battle, first battle in India which company won. After the death of Siraj-ud-Daulah, he was assassinated and in his place Mir Jafar, who was the commander of Siraj-ud-Daulah, was made the Nawab of Bengal, because he was promised by the company that after death of Siraj-ud-Daulah he was made. So he did not cite it Siraj-ud-Daulah, he was made Nawab of Bengal. After some time he started complaining about the company, so the company deposed him. He was thrown out and in his place Mir Qasim was made the Nawab of Bengal. After some time Mir Qasim also started complaining about the company, so again company reinstalled Mir Jafar in his place. After becoming the Nawab of Bengal, again Mir Jafar has to pay 5 lakh rupees monthly, 5 lakh rupees monthly to the company, and company did not want to take the total responsibility of the administration. They wanted to expand their business. Their main motive was to expand their business. In 1765, Mir Jafar died. And after Battle of Plassey, the Britain stopped sending gold and silver coins which were used to sell in India before Battle of Plassey. For that, the company themselves, they became Nawabs. They declared themselves as Nawabs. And Robert Clive became the Nawab himself. They wanted more money for the war expenditure and administration of their company, and as already Britain has stopped to selling their gold and silver in India. Only one was left, the revenue from India can be used for the war and for administration of the company, and for that they have to depend on the local rulers. When nobody was left after death of Mir Jafar, the company declared themselves as Nawabs. It means not only to get power but to expand their territories. Their trade and territories has to be expanded. But the problem started, the company servants, they started living like Nawabs. Themselves, their vision was to live like Nawabs. And Robert Clive came in India at the age of 18. And he made lot of wealth in India. After some time, the Britain Parliament asked Robert Clive to check the corruption of company officials in India. Later on, the company cross-examined Robert Clive himself, and he was caught in corruption. So when he was caught, he committed suicide. In 1772, he committed suicide. many other company officials also died in between because of war and diseases. But all of them were not dishonest. Many of them were very honest rulers. Many died during wars, and some of them they died because of diseases, but all were not dishonest. Later on, they were ridiculed. Fun was made on them because they became the nawabs. As in Hindi, it is called nawab. So they become nawabs of India. Now the company has to expand its rule. For that, what they did? They wanted to expand their trade and their territories. So they applied many methods to establish their territory. And in that, what they did, the company really launched. Did not launch direct attack, but made different methods to acquire the territories. And for that, after the Battle of Buxar, the company appointed residents in Indian states. They were politically or commercial agents, and their job was to serve the company. And these residents were the Mughal emperors. They were made residents. They did not have any economic or political power. Their duty was only to serve the company, so that they will under the control of the company, and they were made residents, although some estates were given to them. But politically and economically, they were not very influential. Their duty was only to serve. And why they made that? So that they will be under their control and they will serve them with the money and land. And in that, they will overpower the Mughal emperors. They were made residents. Through the residents, the company officials began interfering in the interest affairs of Indian states. Slowly, slowly, when they made the Mughal emperors the residents, they started ruling over them. They tried to decide who was to be the successor of the throne. Slowly, slowly, they got the power, and they themselves decided who will become the ruler of the throne, who will acquire the throne. Sometimes the company forced the state into the subsidiary alliance. They made many methods to acquire their territories. Sometimes the company started subsidiary alliance. According to that terms, Indian ruler who was not allowed to have their independent forces. Subsidiary alliance, the first method the company used. It means the Indian rulers, the residents who were made, they were economically and politically had no power. They cannot keep their own army. The Indian rulers cannot keep their own army. They have to maintain the company army. All expenditure of the company army has to be taken by the Indian ruler. And if they are failed to maintain the company army under them, their territory will be acquired by the company. And many of the states were acquired on subsidiary alliances. So the company was supposed to maintain for the purpose of this protection. If the Indian ruler failed to make the payment, then their territory will be taken away as a penalty. It means the Indian ruler has to maintain the company army. If they are failed, and besides that, they have to pay to the officials, company officials. If they are failed to do so, their territory will be taken as a penalty from that ruler. And in that case, when Richard Wolseley was Governor General in 1798 to 1805, the Nawab of Awadh was forced to give over his territory to the company because of he was failed to pay subsidiary forces. Hyderabad was also forced to cede territories to similar grounds. So two, one is the Awadh and second one is the Hyderabad. Their territories were taken as a penalty because their rulers were considered that they are not able to control the army troops and not able to give to pay the revenue or to maintain the army of the company, and their territories has been taken as the penalty. Awadh and Hyderabad has been taken by the company. The territories has been acquired by the company as a penalty. So let us summarize once again. After the death of Sirajuddaulah, Mir Jafar was made Nawab of Bengal, and after when he complained, he was deposed and Mir Qasim was made. Later on, Mir Qasim also complained. He was installed and again Mir Jafar was reinstalled as the Nawab of Bengal. But after his death, it became difficult for the company. So they were worrying about before Battle of Plassey, the Britain gold and silver was sell in the market and it was stopped and it became difficult for the Nawabs. Difficult for the company to maintain. So themselves they became the Nawabs. Robert Clive was the first one who became declared himself as the Nawab, but other also official servants also started living like Nawabs. Robert Clive came in India at the age of 18. He made lot of wealth. Ultimately, Britain government, parliament told Robert Clive to check the corruption in India under the company. Himself, he was found, he committed suicide. After that, many other company officials were died during the war and disease, but they all of them were not dishonest. And later on, they were made the fall. Now, the company has to maintain the army for the war. They want expenditure. They want to maintain their administration. They applied many means and ways to acquire the territories of India. Slowly, slowly, as a trader they came, they started acquiring the territories. So they made Indian rulers, Mughal rulers, as residents. For the namesake only they made them residents. They did not have any economic or political power. Their duty was to serve the company. And later on, they started subsidiary alliance in which the Indian ruler has to maintain the army expenditure and to maintain the army of the company. And if they are failed to maintain the army of the company, the Indian rulers will not have their own army. They have to maintain the company army. If they are failed to maintain the subsidiary alliance, which means they have to maintain the troops of army under their guidance, they have to give all expenditure for the maintenance of the army. If they are failed, their territories will be taken as a penalty. And among them, the first one's Awadh, the ruler of Awadh, his territory was taken as a penalty. And second one was the Hyderabad. Hyderabad was also taken as a penalty. Other means also they started. We will study that. Hope that children you understood. I'll send you questions regarding of that completed portion you have to do in the notebooks. Till then children, have a nice day. Study well.